This is not going to be great, right? Like, I've only run it through a couple of times, and it's a song I used to listen to a lot when I was a kid because I was a huge U2 fan, right? Rick Beato just about a week ago did one of his YouTube episodes. He did an episode on U2's song Drowning Man from the War album. This is a rather obscure song that not a lot of people are completely aware of, but it is a very complicated and bizarre song. And I was listening to this while my mom was visiting today. This Rick Beato examination of the song. It's got really complicated timing in it. It's got 6/4 time as well as 4/4 time. It's got a lot of jazz sort of influence where they're just kind of winging it, and Bono's kind of jumping in at weird spots in the music. The timing is very weird, and he also makes the comparison that it sounds like a hymn. And the reason, okay, I don't know if Rick Beato says that he's been going to U2 concerts for 30 years. They've been around for 40 years. They've been around for 40 years. And so he may not be aware that U2 at one point almost became a religious themed band. So for those of you who have any sort of affinity for U2, U2 almost became a religious band, and it was when they made their second album, the album before this one, the album before War. They almost became a religious band, and that was when they made October, and they did Gloria. Gloria in Deo Domine. They almost became a religious band, but they got some pressure from the church that they were getting into that they were uncomfortable with. And Adam, the bassist, the only person who really knew how to play his instrument, was not down with this because I think he's gay. I think he's gay, actually, you guys. He was not down with this, so he nixed that. That did not happen. They did not become a religious band. But if you notice, like if you're a YouTube fan, you'll notice that they do have a lot of religious themes in a lot of their music. They really do. So for those of us who are lightly religious, like I'm a non-practicing Catholic, right? So I'm lightly religious. This sort of music really draws us in because of the religious influence, but at the yet the same time, they also talk a lot about, well, we're sinners though. We're totally fucking sinners. So this particular song, Rick Beato says it sounds like a hymn. I did leave a comment on his channel, and I'm like, well, that's because they literally almost became a religious band. Of course, it sounds like a hymn because this is what they do. So I'm gonna try this. This song is really complicated. The timing is really weird. It's one of these songs I used to listen to when I was in junior high, like 7th grade junior high. So we're talking 86, 87. And it's very sad. It's a really fucking sad song. It's called Drowning Man. And I'm not gonna be able to do this perfect because I haven't been listening to it in a long time. It's one of their more obscure songs. It's off of the War album, which is a fucking phenomenal album. By the way, War has like Sunday Bloody Sunday on it. It has Two Hearts Beat as One. It's got a lot of stuff on it that's really, really good. Oh, there's another song on that song, on that album I might want to do. I was just thinking of it. Takes a second to say goodbye, oh. I might do that one too. But this one, okay, this one's kind of complicated and it's really at the top of my range. So let's try it. Hopefully my camera won't flip again. That's so weird that it keeps doing that.
I'll be there if you can. I'll cross the sky. for your love. For I have promised for to be with you tonight and for the time that will come.
So it's really wild that he actually decided to analyze that song, because not a lot of people have heard that song. You'd have to pretty much be a U2 fan to have heard that song before. And it wasn't radio played. It didn't get radio play, and they have never done it in concert. That was something that Rick Beato mentioned in his analysis of this particular song. He mentioned that they've never performed it live. It's only on the album, on the War album. And so you have to be a U2 fan to actually have heard the song before. And it is very complicated. It's a really, it does have very bizarre timing to it. It's a very mournful, soulful song. And that's so wild that he covered it. That guy covers so much music that you wouldn't expect him to do. He's all over the place. I love that channel. So if you're into music, if you're into music theory, if you're into music instruction, that's a great channel to follow. That guy knows his shit. He knows his shit. And that is a very complicated song. And I remember singing along to that, like when I was, in the seventh grade. I loved that song. But it has been a very long time since I've actually popped the War album in and listened to it, like, front to back. There are some, it takes a second to say goodbye, say goodbye. Oh, oh, oh. New Year's Day is on that album, too. New Year's Day is also on that album. I was telling my mom while I was watching this video, and I'm like, this is so fascinating that he's covering this song. I was saying, you know, what's really interesting is these kids, when they were kids, Larry Mullen was basically in like high school drum line or something, right? He put up a notice on like one of these pin boards at his high school and was like, hey, I want to form a band. Come and audition. The only person who actually had any musical ability was Adam Clayton. He was the only one who actually knew how to play his instrument. Bono showed up and he just naturally had a great voice, right? Edge did not know how to play his guitar. There were some of the other people who showed up for the audition included the Edge. His real name is Dave Evans. His brother showed up as well, and so did Bono's best friend. Bono's real name is Paul Hewson. His best friend showed up as well. The two of them, Budgie, and I can't remember Dave Evans' brother's name. I can't remember his name. They formed the Virgin Prunes. And that band went on to be a cult favorite of goths, right? So they formed the Virgin Prunes, and Bono has done some collaborative work with Budgie because that is his best friend. That's his best friend. But obviously U2 became like a world famous band, and the Virgin Prunes became a goth cult classic. Bono and Budgie did a song for that Daniel Day-Lewis movie. The one where he and his father get arrested inaccurately. They were rounded up as being part of like a terrorist attack in England as part of the IRA, and they didn't do it, and the real culprit had been arrested on different charges. Bono and Budgie did a collaborative song for that movie that's really good too. It's a really good song. I know I have really weird U2 knowledge in my head. Anyway, that's a great song. That's a great song. It's very sad and mournful. Yeah, I cried a lot when I was in junior high, I'll be real.